Hi, I'm Tony Bellamy, and welcome to Just Coolin', where hip-hop meets bebop, and bebop meets hip-hop, and the many flavors of jazz. On today's show, we pay tribute to Lester Young, saxophonist and clarinetist. Lester was a jazz original, an idiom in style, music, and language, surviving Jim Crow racism. Lester Young was born in Woodville, Mississippi, August 27, 1909, to Billy Young, a traveling bandleader, and Lizetta Johnson. He grew up in New Orleans with his mother, nurtured on music. Lester looked like his mother, light skin and green eyes, and adored her. But that all changed when his parents separated and his father got custody. Billy Young took his son and family to Minneapolis and throughout the South as a traveling minstrel show. It was here that Lester first played the drums and then the sax, and also how to play the clarinet. Lester's father was a taskmaster who demanded discipline, and Lester Young's languid attitude was quite the opposite, which frustrated his father. It was Lester's personality never to confront, but remain calm. But in the South, the family's musical travels encountered racism and lynching throughout Jim Crow America. These experiences greatly affected Lester Young's spirit as a child. The final straw was escaping a lynch mob in his early teens with his cousin. Lester Young left his family at age 18, moving to Kansas City for a better life. From these experiences, Lester developed a code or language that followed him throughout his life, such as when confronted with a racist, he would say, "I feel a draft," or "Von Hangman is here." This was just the beginning of Lester Young being the first to say it's cool or wear dark glasses on the stage to hide his high or have a tutu moments. A relaxed, calm attitude coming from the ancient Yoruba African culture, similar to Zen. By Lester's mid-20s, Lester developed a tenor sax sound that sounded like an alto. His major influence was Frankie Trombauer to this style of playing. Lester's music was nothing like Coleman Hawkins' dominant, deep sound of that time. Lester was not about playing what happened in 1949, but what you play today. Lester's sound was free-floating, changing from note to note, not harsh, but smooth. At age 24, he was part of the Basie Band, and Lester's music was so creative on such Basie classics as 1 O'Clock Jump, Every Tub, and Old Lady Be Good. In 1934, Lester was playing at Club Reno with Basie and jazz impresario John Hammond first heard him over experimental radio in a car. The Reno Club stage was cramped, so Lester held his sax and arms extended at an angle to avoid poking his fellow musician. This style became a trademark, and many sax players copied only because it looked cool. In 1937, John Hammond got the Basie Band, including Lester Young, along with Billie Holiday, to record for Decca Records. It was a legendary recording, where Holiday and Young on the tune, This Year's Kisses, set the mood. It was Lester's solos and Billie's singing on the songs Why I Was Born, I Must Have That Man. Their sound became two voices. Lester started calling Billie Holiday Lady Day, and she called Lester Young Prez, a name that stuck with Lester Young throughout his musical career. This musical session transformed Holiday and Young into legends. Her emotional vocals and Lester's solos developed cool jazz. Lester also developed and created his own creative hip slang or language. He coined the phrase for New York City, the Big Apple, crib for one's home and bread for money. It would end sentences, you dig? But when it came to dress, Prez had his legendary pork pie hat that became a trademark. Sharp pinstripe suits, double-breasted vests, and pointy Cuban shoes. But Lester's world changed in 1944 when he was arrested for drug charges by an undercover FBI agent. Lester was sent to Alabama's Fort McClellan to join the military service, where he was tortured, beaten, and put in a padded cell for a picture found with a white woman, a no-no at that time. After military doctors treated Lester for his delusions, the court found him to be a psychopath, and he was dishonorably discharged in 1945. After this experience, the Prez had changed his playing and was more melancholy, some say. But in a recent discovered 1959 interview, the Prez desired to learn new music, quite the opposite, an upbeat attitude. But Lester's increased drinking started to take its toll on his health, with declining physical strength and not eating. The Prez made his final studio recordings and live performances in Paris in 1959. Lester Young died at age 49, March 15, 1959, after just arriving in New York. He was buried in Evergreen Cemetery in Brooklyn. Goodbye, Pork Pie Hat. Lester's left town. And now, more music here on WJAZ with the Prez.